Another fun way to use JavaScript on web pages is to animate properties over time. Before we can do that, however, I need to make sure that you know about another global variable that is available on every web page, the window variable. Here, I will console.log it, and you can pause, check out your dev tools, and see what's inside it. Did you see? It is huge. It contains so much. It is overwhelming. To make it a little less overwhelming, I will tell you some of my favorite properties and methods that you can access on it. There is window.location, which has a bunch of information about the URL of the page. And actually, let's go and just write that out to the page so that you don't have to keep pausing. So textconf 10, and then we're just going to say the URL of this page is window.location, and then that's an object, so we need to reach inside and say .href. And there you go. That's actually the URL of the iframed web page on the side. Another property is window.navigator.useragent, which tells you about the browser of the user. So we say the browser that you would call the user agent is plus window.navigator.useragent. Okay, that user agent string probably looks pretty crazy to you. It's not really meant to be human readable, and it doesn't always make a lot of sense for historical reasons. So most web developers use libraries to actually understand what that string means and what browser they're on and what OS and all of that, because it is very weird. And here's one that's not so weird. So window.outerWidth and window.outerHeight. So let's say this web page is, window.outerWidth, so we'll do the width first, by window.outerHeight. So it says, to me it says 1280 by 715, but maybe it says something different to you depending on what your web page looks like when you're viewing this talk through. Now, let me show you something a little surprising. I'm going to delete the window part of this line of code. And so what happens is that it still works. That is because window is the default global variable on web pages. When the browser looks for a variable that you use, it will look for it on the window object. And when you create a new global variable, the window object will actually store it as a property. That means that you should not declare your own variables named outer width and outer height, because then they'll override window.outer width and window.outer height. Generally, you should avoid global variables altogether, since it's so easy for them to collide with each other or existing variables on the window. To be extra safe, you can prefix your global variables. Like at Khan Academy, we write KA underscore in front of any global variables that we have to have. Okay, so that's the window object. Now we're going to see how you can use two functions on it to make animations.